Good morning. How are you doing? Thanks for being here. There we go. Okay, I believe our live stream is up and rolling. Be sure to check in. Let me know where you're watching and listening from today. So glad that you are here. Well, first of all, quick update. I mentioned yesterday that I had gone to a family gathering this past weekend to visit kids and grandkids and among the group, and there's quite a few of us, four ended up testing positive for COVID right afterward, one of which is my wife, Vicky. And so quick update on her. She's hanging in there. She was feeling rough last night. Thankfully, this is not, I don't think it's as harsh had it been the first wave of COVID or even the second wave of COVID. But I mean, she's running a fever and, you know, headache. So she said her throat hurts more than anything else, but it seemed to kind of hit a fever pitch last night, and just in terms of the discomfort. So hopefully I'll be checking in with her. Of course, I moved out to another room because I'm still testing negative. So that's good. That's good. So I'll be checking on her right after this video to see how she's doing this morning, but glad that you're here. And again, I hope you're doing well. And I wanted to take just a few minutes to talk about something, being that if you look at the universe of voiceover work, everything that's out there, you're going to find that the vast majority of it's going to be more corporate, long-form related. It doesn't have to be corporate. I mean, it could be audiobooks, anything from audiobooks to e-learning and everything in between. That's going to be, sure, there's promos, there's commercials, but that's not the bulk of the work. It's going to be this longer form narration. And so it took me a while earlier in my career to kind of get a flow, to figure out what worked best for me. So again, what my caveat here is, this is what works best for me. So you can try it out, use it for yourself, see if it works best for you. You might find some tweaks or things that work better for you. I don't believe necessarily that, you know, every answer to voiceover is a one size fits all. I think you have to, I mean, there are some principles, overarching principles that are always true. But in terms of, like, yesterday we talked about stand or sit. Well, you know, do whatever makes you feel, number one, most comfortable. Number two, helps you perform the best. You know, there are no rules in that regard. And it's the same thing with this. But I wanted to share with you what I do. What I'm talking about is how I work with the script itself, not necessarily the performance of the script. This is how, you know, how do I technically work with the script to help me? Because sometimes I'm working with, you know, usually it's going to be in the, you know, 3 to 4 page range, but sometimes I'll get a 20 page, 30 page, 50 page, and audiobooks could go hundreds, obviously. And so you don't need to read that in one sitting. You know, you read as long as you're able to read and maintain, you know, the same consistent delivery. And then you take breaks, and that's going to be different for everybody. But again, just want to share a few thoughts that helped me along the way. So what I'm going to do, let's see here. I've got a script. Let me see if I can just do a quick change here so I can share my screen with you. So hopefully you can see all that. And what I'm going to do is bring up a script. And again, hopefully you can see this. Okay, let me make it. This is just, it's less than a page. It's pharmaceutical related. And let me double check, make sure that that's showing up. I believe it is. Okay, there we go. All right. So what helps me to find my flow, to get in a rhythm, to minimize mistakes, and that's big for me, minimizing mistakes. Mistakes take time. I mean, everybody makes mistakes, but you don't want to be stumbling. Now, in this case, this is pharmaceutical. You know, if you're like me, you're going to spend a lot of time researching pronunciations. But aside from that, what will allow me to find a comfortable flow where I can read it and not worry, or at least minimize the mistakes that I make, unnecessary mistakes? Well, I do a couple of things. One is I want the font to be at a size that's comfortable for me, but I want it to be the smallest it can be, but comfortable, because the bigger it is, the more scanning I'm going to have to do, because it takes up more real estate, each font. So right now that's like at 14 point. Let me just try a 12 point. I usually work with about a 12 point font. And that looks, yeah, that looks pretty good to me. I mean, I could zoom in. I'm using Microsoft Word. I could zoom that in a little bit, make it just look slightly larger. So that's where I begin. But what really helps me is the width. How much real estate of that document am I going to allow the script to take up? And what I find is that the more that I have to scan from left to right, and then once you get to the end of a sentence, you've got a long way to scan back to the left to start over again. The longer that space and real estate is, the more mistakes that I make. And again, I just stumbled over this and figured this out over a course of several years earlier on in my career. So what I like to do within Microsoft Word, I go to the layout pull-down menu up here, and then over to the left, it says margins. And what I like to do is I like to go from normal, which is what this is set up, normal margins, to wide margins. And when I go to wide margins, look what it does. It keeps the font the size that I want it, but it doesn't allow, well, it just makes larger margins. It doesn't allow the script to flow so far from left to right. And what that allows me to do is just kind of go back and, go back and forth in small, I'm having a hard time finding my words this morning, but I don't have to go a long way from left to right and then a long way back to the beginning to the left, because I found that the longer those lines were, the more mistakes that I made. But when I don't have to scan my eyes so much, it just kind of flows straight from top to bottom as opposed from left to right. Of course, you could get to a point of being ridiculous and you could make it, I'd have to modify it. But, I can make the margins even larger, but it gets to the point, if I'm only reading three words per line, then it gets to be a bit ridiculous and just the opposite happens. It becomes difficult again. But right here, for me, this flows. And I don't have to move my head, my eyes so much to see everything. It just kind of goes from top to bottom. It's just a little tip / trick that I use that helps me. If you struggle finding your flow when it comes to reading longer form narration, you might want to try it out and see if it works for you. Again, when it comes to voiceover is not a one-size-fits-all thing when it comes to these little strategies. You have to try what and find what works best for you. And that's what I've done over the years. I've taken things that I've learned, that I've heard, or some I've just shots in the dark, I'll just try. Because when you're doing, eventually, as you market yourself and your business grows, and if you're working all day long in a studio, you need to find ways to be as efficient as possible. Otherwise, it can be voiceover, it's pretty physically demanding, I think more than people realize, from both a physical and an emotional standpoint, because especially if you're doing commercial and promo reads, there's a lot of emotion that goes with that. So again, anything that you can do to be efficient in your work and to help you minimize your mistakes and just the physical output that you have to produce is going to help you do a better job and feel better at the end of the day as well, which I think is important as well. So anyhow, there you go. I hope you find it helpful. That's, for me, the best way to read voiceover long-form narration. And I hope it works well for you. Okay, let's see. Who do we have on today? Hey, Bruce and Mark and Marla and Lawrence and Rafiq and Rob and Bruce and Joe and Courtney. We've got, Texas, North Carolina, David from Louisville. Man, you are faithful. You're here every morning, and I appreciate that. Many of you are. Excuse me. I hope that you're finding these tips helpful, because if you are, I'll keep doing it. I'll keep coming in and just sharing some thoughts to start the day, because, any business is hard enough. It's, excuse me, it's a challenge. And anything that you can do to reduce the amount of stress, unnecessary stress, the better. The things that you can do to be more efficient, and sometimes it's just a 1% tweak. Hello from Ireland. Hey, Ahmed, how are you doing? All right. Paul in Eastern Kentucky. Rebecca in Michigan. Cheyenne, hope I'm pronouncing that right, from Nashville. Awesome. Good to have you guys on this morning. I sure appreciate it. I love the bite-sized tidbits each day, Courtney says. Okay, cool. Yeah, thank you. Oh, good. Well, we'll keep doing it. But again, I just find it, if it's a 1% tweak to make things a little bit easier and better, it just makes the job more fun. It allows me to be more productive, which ultimately helps me meet my goal of being more profitable. That's what it's all about. So again, I hope it helps you. So I'm going to wrap it up because I've got work I've got to attend to today, and I hope you do as well. Even if you don't have voiceover work to record, marketing. Always be marketing. And that's the way you keep your business rolling forward. Have a great day, guys. Thanks for being